Something happened to me a couple of weeks ago. It's amazing. I shared it with a couple of people, but I would like to share it with my brothers and my sisters. You see, a few years ago, I had to have an operation on my knees. That didn't go very well. But with all of that, I didn't give up. I had lots of prayers for me, and it did work. About a couple months ago, the doctor gave me some pills, and he says, oh, you have to take them because they can help with the pain. Because for over 6 years, I was having pain. I looked okay, I looked normal, but the pain was there. In February, one night, I woke up. I said to my husband, I'm not going to take these pills anymore. I've had it, I'm fed up. The pain is still there. It lasts about an hour. They say to take it 4 hours. It lasts about an hour, the pain is still there. I got up, I throw those pills out. I phoned my sister, which is Mrs. D. That's the Abba, by the way. I said to her, I'm not going to take any of these pills because it's making my stomach sick. She says, well, then you shouldn't take it. A couple weeks ago, I said to my husband, I don't feel like going to church this morning. He said to me, why? I said, because this pain is too much for me. I don't want to drive, and I don't want to go. But I have this stuff, and I have to take it to church for me. He says, no. Surprising to me. He usually say no, but not all the time. But that Saturday, he said, 2 Sundays ago, he says, no, you have to go and you have to take it. I said, okay. I looked at him. Oh, I really wanted to say something, but I didn't. I didn't. So I got dressed. He took the stuff to the car. He says, just be careful. I didn't grumble. I wanted to also, but I just did it. I sang all the way to church. I got here, the pain was, I said, I'm going to get on this car, I'm going to walk, put the stuff in, and go back home. But it didn't work like that. As I was coming in, my brother made me, that was Eric, and he says, what's wrong? I was thinking about you on me, something is wrong. So he says, can I talk to you? I says, sure. Do you have anything on me to talk? I explained to him. And he began to pray for me. I said, this pain is too much for me today. I really can't take it. And brother, make something amazing happen. While he was praying for me, my body becomes absolutely numb. The tears was coming down, my body was not shaking, but very warm on the inside. He asked, what happened? What's going on? I couldn't say anything. It's as though I couldn't speak at that moment. I looked at him and I said, I have to stand up. I stood up and I didn't believe it, but I had no pain. Absolutely no pain in my right leg. That leg that I had to drive it. I says, I have no pain. The pain is gone. And on my left leg, where I had the operation, it's like something pulled the back of my knee. And that makes my knees feel as though, what happened? I'm standing straight. I used it to be like on the side, but now I'm standing straight. So I said to Eric, something happened. Thank you, God, for what you have done for me today. If I didn't leave my home, it probably wouldn't happen. But everything happened for a reason. And that's the reason why I had to leave home this morning. And I looked at him and said, God is merciful. He is wonderful. And whatever we think we're going through, it will take some time. But remember, don't give up. Because there is a God who we can trust and believe in. We have to have that faith. Sometimes we'll get down, but we have to wait right back up. I looked at my brother this morning, and I said, Gary, I looked at Gary and I said, I know what you're going through, you're okay. I've been there. But for the past 2 weeks, Barbara, I can move my head. This is the bad leg, I couldn't bring it up. This is the good one. And I have no pain. I have 5% more bending in the left knee. And I want to say, thank you, God, for all the wonderful things that you're doing for each and every one of us.